Sonic players now. Okay, but here we are. We are going into Raito versus FOW. Now, this is going to be a really intense matchup, you know. Ness with a lot of projectiles that can honestly contest with a lot of Duck Hunt setups. And, you know, yeah. Duck Hunt is going to have to get creative with his recovery, you know.
It's crazy what you can do with Duck Hunt.
Right.
It's really amazing what you can pull off with Duck Hunt. He's got the banjo tag. Really, Shona, I was excited
dude,
when banjo was
dude, I mean, the...
Dragon Quest was cool, though.
Dragon
Don't
Quest,
get
yeah.
me wrong. Don't get
yeah.
me wrong.
I mean, yeah, Dragon Quest is cool, though. I kind of just want to play the hero just so I can kamikaze people.
Oh, my God. That's looking this crazy. Yeah.
Dude, that kamikaze is like if you took KO Punch and made it, like,
yeah.
off the screen. And that is kamikaze.
It's the thing is that, like, watching him already practice Duck Hunt stuff with his can is already terrifying.
Dude, I mean...
Which is really terrifying. You ever just see someone SD on accident in warm-ups?
Hey. Rather do it during a button check.
That's true. That is true. Really impressive showing at Mango.
Oh, yes.
It was amazing. Like, it was a really good set against Elegant, but then Elegant really turned it up and then got a download on him. But this tournament, he's been doing really well, really showing what he can do as this Duck Hunt. Duck Hunt's a character that people really sleep on. Because he's just not played.
I mean, Duck Hunt's one of those characters that very few play because very few are able to master Duck Hunt to the level where it's actually tournament viable. Mm-hmm.
That's just the Japanese work ethic. Like, they'll pick any character and they'll master them, no matter who it is. Like, Smash 4.
They'll be like, I like this character.
I'm going to play him.
And I don't care what anybody else says, I'm going to make him good.
Yeah, like... Remember, everyone was doubting Duck Hunt Smash 4, and then he placed, what was it, top 8 at EVO?
Yeah.
It was just crazy, but here we go.
I mean, you can make a very strong call for, you know, Raito being like a top 10 player in the world.
Yeah,
you know?
I think so too. Raito, it's not just of the matchup infamiliarity with the Duck Hunt. It's just that Raito knows so many mechanics with Duck Hunt, it's crazy. You can't keep up with him. He's got so many grab confirms. He's got so many, what was it, Frisbee confirms?
So many traps, so many, like, tricky setups.
Uh-huh.
You know, there's a lot of things that Duck Hunt can do that, you know, that he does things that no other Duck Hunt does.
Uh-huh. And call it campy, but he's winning. That's the thing.
Yeah.
Call it lame, he's winning. It's like everyone complaining about Justin Long. Remember, everyone's just like, oh, he's so lame, he's campy. He's winning them.
Yeah.
He's winning games.
I mean, it's win or adapt, though. Like, complaining about it, like, he's not going to stop doing what he's doing if it gets success, you know?
No Johns.
Yeah.
No Johns. So, hopping right into it back. So, Raito already setting up camp and really walling this Ness out already with this can. It's just so good. Look at this setup that's happening. It comes out of nowhere. And here comes the can trying to get him out of that situation.
I mean, yeah, he tried bailing it out, but not quite enough.
Goodness.
Yeah. So, Ness, a lot of things, you know, will... He has to get in somehow, but he's going to mainly do it with his projectiles, and that's actually interesting, you know?
Oh, it's because the PK fire was on the can.
Right.
So it the hitbox was still there.
And it was right at ledge.
Yeah.
And he probably air dodge off stage.
Uh-huh. So that's a stock really given by FOW. Fall?
FOW.
FOW? So yeah. FOW really needs to use it. Look at, like, how do you expect that with the can coming at you at Mach 5, straight from Jibin, that barely missed.
Oh my god, and then all these, PK Magnet. PK Magnet is actually, like, an amazing tool to use.
What is that? What is that?
He, like, bounced it off of the wall.
Did you see FOW's face? He literally opened his eyes wide. He's like, what? That's crazy. Raito
is a madman. He is like, I am the third player. I am the sniper.
Oh, my God. Like, what are you supposed to do against that? That is crazy, but... Oh my god. So, but still remember, Raito is still at disadvantage, though.
Right.
He's still at percent disadvantage. And nearly needs to do his best to get back. But.
Yet again, FOW's able to keep his advantage state pretty well, you know. No, honestly, like, a very good. All he needs is a grab at this point.
Yeah. That's all he really needs. But at the same time, there we go. Gets the trade off. So, Raito, I think what Duck Hunt really struggles with is being a disadvantage.
Right.
That's one of the biggest struggles that Duck Hunt has. And using these Frisbee confirms, trying to get the up air, not enough to take it.
And yet again, he
went too deep. He missed the ledge.
I was about to say, you know what, like, he went for that double jump up air, and you know what, he's off stage, he's in disadvantage. If FOW decides to run off and dare him, he's dead.
Oh,
but then I guess he didn't even know he didn't have a double jump at that point.
That match was really given. That was Raito's to lose. And FOW.
Dude, Raito gave up 2 free stocks. Yeah. I mean,
and still almost won. That was the craziest part about it. So FOW, Even FOW shook his head. He knew that he didn't deserve the game, but you have to take
it. I mean, yeah, you take those, but especially when, even though this is top 16, it's still best of three.
Yeah, it is still best of three because this may be a packed tournament with 256 people coming. It's still considered a weekly.
Right. So only top five at winner semis, at semis, basically. So winner semis and loser semis.
So this puts even more pressure on Raito. But what we know about Japanese players, they don't get pressured.
Right.
They don't get pressured. They put the pressure on you, and here we go. So FOW, he's got to use his momentum to his advantage, though. Like, this is so massive for him. That was a match given to him. Like, God, that was godsend, essentially.
Oh, my God, yes. And yet again, FOW just, pulling back his place, I'll be like, okay, what did I lose that match? No, I got into disadvantage a lot. I got hit by a lot of moves. So let me pull back and like play a more spaced out game. No, he's able to get in by getting a grab, throwing PK fire. Uh-huh. So what can I do to avoid all that? And you see it right now. He is just taking this lead with a vengeance.
Yeah, Raito, download complete. Right, that's what he's doing right now. And I love that FOW is using his PK magnet stalls really efficiently. And no zero to death.
I mean, like, 16% is still a long mountain to climb, my
friend. Yeah, and see, the hardest part about playing against Duck Hunt is that usually when you play, you want to keep your eye on your opponent.
Right.
Right? But then you have to keep an eye on his can at the same time.
And the gunman.
And the
gunman, frisbee.
And the frisbee. It's so hard, and these Duck Hunt players know exactly where the can is going. Maybe not just Duck Hunt, it's just Raito, and the F tilt, not able to take it just yet, hits the can a little more and bounces it just so it's at the edge and misses the opportunity to get anything. But 31% at 151, Ness.
I mean, I like the idea, you know, using the board smash to kind of reflect it back. You know, it is a reflector, but at the same time, you know, it's a really hard commitment, and if you misspace it,
which happened, just there, and he missed it, and now he's at 184, a lot of rage, but if FOW gets hits it, it could be massive.
Right. I mean, I guess that's the one thing, is that when you're playing a Duck Hunt that plays this patient and careful, you know, can isn't going to kill until like that 200%.
But it still does so much damage, though. Right. That's the thing. And can will kill earlier if you're off stage too, which we've seen multiple times happen already.
Right.
So FOW, he's got a long hill to climb, but it's not impossible.
I mean, yeah. Yet again, like 82%, that is kill percent, you know? So all he needs to do is just be like, okay, I may be taking a lot of damage, you know? You might be getting a little couple of combos on me. Those aren't going to kill me. I'm not going to die until 150, 200%. If I can just kill you before that, then I can win the set and win the game.
Yeah, it's just really hard, and I love the magnet stall into the jab. It tried to mix it up with the down smash, unable to get it, though. Trying to hit that can away. Thankfully, it's a disjoint.
Right.
Or else it would be a disaster for Ness to deal with. So FOW doing a good job, but he runs right back into the can. Remember, Raito's at 140. He's got a lot of rage to work with.
Yeah. The one unfortunate thing is that even if you hit can, after a little bit, like, Duck Hunt gets can back. So.
Ooh, hits it away. So he's got Raito. So no more rage, but oh my God, FOW at 122 already.
I mean, you don't need a whole lot of rage when you're at that high percent.
Yeah. So, and remember, with Gunman, it's RNG what you get,
No, I believe,
or is it a cycle?
It cycles.
It cycles, okay. But the black one is the best one, apparently, unless it travels the fastest.
They're, like, each Gunman travels downwards at different speeds, and they shoot at different speeds.
Okay. All right, so that's really, that just shows more on what Raito needs to know. It's kind of crazy what you have to do. And here we go. Gets the grab into the down throw. No up air gonna hit.
And you saw FOW kind of hesitating to go in because he saw the can and be like, if I don't worry about this can, then I might get hit when I try to get punished.
Oh, did you see that can? Oh my, it's just crazy what he can pull off, and that fire is only gonna make it worse. My goodness, Raito is on another plane of existence. He's got a third eye on his controller. He knows exactly what's happening.
Yet again, the unfortunate thing is that he hit it with PK Fire, and PK Fire does not get rid of can.
Uh-huh.
So, yet again, FOW's going to have his work cut out for him if he wants to deal with both the can and Duck Hunt. You know, this is what we see when a player doesn't SD, like, two stocks, you know? It's going to be a lot harder to take this victory. And you see FOW trying to get back to the PK Thunder 2, trying to get in with that Thunder Cheese, but yet again, unfortunately, running out of juice just a little bit too late.
It's just that FOW's looking for an opportunity to get in, but Raito's just not letting him get anything out of it. And it just shows how dominant he is on this character, and Raito already has a stock left to spare, and thankfully the magnet pushes it away. Really unfortunate that doesn't absorb it.
it really, Thunder Magnet doesn't absorb explosion?
No.
I thought it would, you know, it seems like an explosion there.
I think maybe it does, but the back throw finally takes it. Foe's got a big hill to climb, but it's not impossible. But when the can confirm comes just like that, not enough to take it, but so close.
I mean, one more can, one more up air, and I would even argue probably like back throw.
Oh my, what are you supposed to do? You can't escape from that Raito.
I feel like another frustrating thing in the matchup is that because Ness is so floaty with his double jump, you know, he's not able to move around the can really fast, you know, be like, okay, I see it coming, but what am I going to do? I can't drift away because I'm so slow in the air. Like,
I just want to see how much damage Raito did. Each
stock was easily 160, 180%.
Yeah, it's just crazy. Like, people can argue saying that Duck Hunt, that means he struggles to kill, but Raito's just like, okay.
I mean, you can struggle to kill all you want, but if you're getting the kill before your opponent, I mean, what does it matter?
Like, what does it matter when your opponent can't even touch you?
Right. It's like the DK versus Richter, or like the Belmont matchup. Yeah. Like, DK will lift it 200%, and Belmont, like, should not get touched, but like, if DK gets in, like, Belmont's screwed. You know? So, like, it's a very polarizing matchup, and like this match, you know, Ness, once Ness gets in, Raito's eating 50%, no, 50, 60%, but yet again, it's getting past all the projectiles, all the cans, all the setups, you know, in order to get in.
So we're switching to FD, which I agree. I think the duo platform is just not good for FOW. I don't think it just works out.
Because a lot more setups, you know, be like, okay, can's going to be on the platform, cover your retrieve option there.
Having a linear stage like this is just much better for him, using the Nair to cover the option.
Ooh, I like that
there to go.
Yet again, this is his advantage. He needs to push out as hard as he can.
He's going to air dodge and tries to get the spike, unable to get it. Foe knows he's in an advantage, but right, just like that, Raito just snatches it away, saying, "We're going back to the neutral."
Right. Be like, "You failed to kill me. Yeah. You should have aimed for the head."
You should have aimed for the head. But it's just Raito is—it's so good. Look at it—he's covering everything. Like, anytime Foe thinks he's at an advantage, Raito immediately goes back to the neutral game and just gets away with it.
Yet again, you know, all these projectiles, you know, Foe struggling to get in, you know, like if he stays in shield, that's going to be a grab for Raito, and it's so hard for Foe to like finally close in this gap. Oh, he almost got hit by that up air too, but manages to land with a fair and get Raito into disadvantage.
And I
liked what he tried doing. He tried rolling back, maybe potentially getting
a grab. Oh my goodness, great tech.
Yet again.
Not punished just yet, but that can is flying out, forces out the air dodge, but no punish.
Yet again, trading with the can, but
so close, that can gets hit up by the PK fire.
I like that, using that PK fire to kind of be like, okay, your can's gonna stop here.
And gets hit up anyways.
But I mean, at this point, he only needs a grab, you know. I like his use of PK fire.
Yeah.
PK fire, like, it may not hit Raito, but it keeps him locked into place, and he can't use the can anymore.
And uses the Nair, not enough to take it just yet, but one PK Thunder, another one, uses the Nair from Duck Hunt to cancel it out.
Right. Oh, God. Foe kind of jumping over the can, you know, manages to use the PK fire. You know, can's all the way on the other side of the screen, but it doesn't matter.
Yep. But uses the Nair, not just enough. Oh, this is aggravating if your Foe really wants to get the stock fast, and it's just not happening. Duck Hunt getting away with it, 70% already on Foe. Duck Hunt with rage, especially on Raito, is infuriating to play against.
Right. Because at this point, you're just like, I want to kill. Give me that kill.
He can't get it.
Yeah. Pretty much like that one guy with the fence. Let me in.
Go. And not enough to take it just yet. Using the can once more into the throw, misses the confirm with it,
right,
but forces Foe into a horrible position offstage, just like that.
Yet again, Raito has him offstage once more, you know, but that air dodge, you know, Ness was probably the best air dodge distance to grab back to ledge with. You know, it's so hard to edge guard it because of that.
And there we go, Tick's taken out. Raito only on 3 stocks. Nothing's taken. But the forward throw into the fair, it's so good. Raito's just running away with this game. Back throw finally takes it. Foe's gonna need a miracle to come back from this one.
I mean, yeah. What he really needs is that he needs a clean edge guard and just eliminate Raito stock as soon as possible. And here we go. There's the fair, and then yet again the PK fire, and then the dare. But unfortunately, the dare misses. Yep. That was his chance right there in order to even up the stocks. But unfortunately, Raito is going to make sure
What is this confirmed?
Yep.
It's crazy what Raito can come up with.
dude. Raito's just like, okay, that was your chance to even up the stocks. I messed up. I lost neutral once. That's only going to happen once because you're not going to get that opportunity again.
You only had one chance and you blew it. 131% on FOW. Needs to recover. Got to tech that one. Great use of that. The cannibal's ready. Raito, he knows he's just one step away from finishing at the can frame one. It's just so good. Hits him up with another one. What does he finish it off with?
Yet again, one more can. One can at ledge. And yet again.
Uses the tilt. The duck finally takes it. Raito, he turned it up. Yeah. That was crazy.
Definitely, you know, Raito, a very master at his craft, you know. So once he set up camp, once he got into his flow, once he got into his rhythm, FOW couldn't really do a whole lot about
it.
Yeah,
there wasn't much.
No, maybe at the low percents, like when he did get that grab, get that fair chain, you know, put him off stage, you know, put him in disadvantage. That was his one chance to kind of like even things up. But no, Raito just be like, okay, I know what you're looking for. You're looking for that dare. I'm not going to give it to you as much as possible. Let me recover super low so that if you go for that dare, you're not coming back either.
All right, so.